So, hello and welcome again to a new video. And today we're going to have a look at everything crypto related, and we are basically going to start off by looking at the Phantom Network, because we have been joining a new farm that came out today. And if that sounds interesting, well, I suggest you should leave a like, comment and subscribe, because that helps out the channel quite a lot. If we could reach 4k subs by the end of the month, that would be awesome. And with that being said, let's get started. So looking over on screen, we already found 0.76 Scream at a current price of 68 cents, so around 50 bucks again overnight. Not overnight, my bad, over a few days, which is not too bad at all, considering you can yield farm with it over on most farms, but not on Phantom Pop, sadly. If that would happen, that would be great, because we are in with the native one, and so far token didn't perform good. But the new farm that came out today actually is doing something better. Like, I bought back in at around $600 or so, and we got now one token in total, so only $600, because we only tested out with a few to see how we farm, and we might invest another, I don't know, 2,000 to 3,000 into it to see how it goes, because 20% daily again is not too bad on a new farm, considering the LP you get 33%, so also not too bad. But the impermanent loss is way too high, because if the token is pushing in price, I want to receive more bonus by selling the token for high. Simple as that. Originally planned to buy a few more tokens, but I didn't because of the price impact. Yet I think the liquidity, yeah, is a bit better, 100,000. So it is a fine farm, 2 million already, not too bad. They're gonna have boosts also for the Singapore Draco and also for the native token, so you're gonna have a lot of opportunity there to farm tomorrow. So I would look into it, but I would be careful, because the price might drop tomorrow because of the APR. Because if the APR is going too high, well, people simply sell their rewards, because it makes no sense to compound. Then you would get 100% daily, and that's around 3% in an hour. And if you compound it, yeah, well, it's a GG. But yeah, my strategy is also to compound a bit. I bought one and I made 0.5 already, and I'm taking it and yeah, see how far I can go with this farm. And if it reaches a specific price of around 1,400 or so, I'm going to take profit, because yeah, staying in new farms is not worth it that much, as you can see with Phantom Pop, which dropped quite a lot, and we should have simply sold for 2k profit. But in the end, it doesn't really matter, because we still compound with around 7% daily, so it's fine. Moving over to Terra. So yesterday I put another $10,000 worth of Luna and Psy into the farm. We got around $40 now in Psy in around, I don't know, 20 hours or so farming this. We get rewarded 0.6% daily, so that's also a good thing to do. You simply come over to the vaults, you can deposit your B Luna, get an Luna, take the an Luna, sell half for Psy, and then put it in the LP and farm your rewards. Then for Terra Flocky, we, I don't know, bought another $500 worth of liquidity yesterday as well, because we still got 1.2% daily. And at the moment we found around 30 bucks worth of Flocky, which is also not too bad. Moving over to Star Terra, we got quite lucky. We got a $90 allocation in the pre-sale, and we got around 1,000 token. And that's around $4,800. So that's a lot of profit with one single pre-sale again. So we got around $8,000 worth of pre-sale money waiting for us to be vested, because the Terra and Terra Land. And the next pre-sale that will go on is Kujira, following 2 days, I think. So 3 million will be raised. So this time, hopefully, we get an allocation for a few thousand instead of a few bucks. But it will be profitable again because you only have around 5,000 people participating, and yeah, 3 million in total for an allocation is quite a lot. And yeah, I think you might be able to get around $1,000-$2,000 allocation. Obviously, I try to put the cap in of around 10,000 simply to get the chance at being able to take it. Yeah, for staking, not much happened. We only stake, yeah, the same amount we staked since. I didn't bought more because, yeah, we got in the pre-sale 1,000. So our total position is almost at 30,000 for Star Tower now, which is insane to see. I don't even know where Anker is. Anker is here. We are almost back at 130,000. Yeah. It went down around 5,000 because it dumped a bit, but Luna went back up again, so not much happened. We took the money out of Earn, as I said, and put it into Nexus. We earned around another $100 worth of Anchor, so I'm going to claim it and put it into staking. So let's see. Yeah, we got around $700 already staked and another $100 to follow. So almost at 1,000, so we should get another airdrop for Nexus Protocol as well. And the Terra Floki airdrop in 10 days. So I think around another $10,000 possible to be made for free again. So that's great to see. But yeah, moving over, I didn't borrow more money, but I'm taking out another 10,000, I'm thinking, and putting it into the urn. Or simply do it into Nexus, because yeah, Nexus is paying out great. And the best thing is we bought Luna yesterday before it actually broke out. We got it at $50, now it's at 52 again. So yeah, hopefully it goes back up to 55 again, and we also made profit on it because Nexus token also went up again. It's 5 minutes. Ah, that's 5 minutes. Okay, my bad. We bought somewhere around 32 cents and it's now 33. So that's most likely everything for Tower. Yeah, that's basically it for Tower. One other thing on Avalanche SBB, that's an ohm fork. I just put in around 1,000 to test it out in staking, so you get around, yeah, 1 million or 1 trillion percent APY, and you get for every 8 hours 1.5% of your money, basically, in how to say it, rebasing. So they rebase the token. So yeah, it's an interesting thing to look out for if you know ohm. Olympus DAO, you know how this functions. If not, it's basically like Ampleforth, but it's a fixed version of it. But of course, this is a bit newer, this is a bit more riskier, it's an Avalanche. So yeah, care for that, so don't risk too much. NFTs, let's see what happened. Not much, I guess. Yeah, the only interesting part is at the moment Cool Cats. So the floor, I think, is around 30,000. So let's see what happened to the floor price. 6.2 Ethereum. That's actually higher, I think. Yeah, 30,000. And the price floor for our cool cat, because yeah, you need to consider if you have a rarer one, it's going to be way more worth. And if you look at it, yeah, it's worth 60,000, so that's a decent amount. But yeah, we still not sell below 100,000 because it would be stupid to let go for that cheap because of the upcoming game and a lot more, just like factor in the airdrops we receive all the time. I don't even know, but it should be around 0.4 Ethereum, because We got today another one worth 80 bucks, and last week you got one too, also worth 60 bucks. So yeah, you get airdrops the whole time, and you will also be able to get the milk token soon. And when that happens, well, KuCad is going to explode back in price, because looking at the board, APR Club, where do I have a tree? Jesus, you need to write it out. So yeah, the floor price also is still at 30 ETH. So you still can get a board ape for 150,000, which is considered cheap, because I think they will go up to even 300,000 when Coinbase releases their NFT marketplace, because at the moment there's just not a lot of people know how NFTs are working, and OpenSea and the gas fees and whatsoever. And if you just look at the sales and you only look at rare stuff, you see a lot of apes sell for over 300,000 already, and considering the rare ones that sell for over millions, it's only a matter of time until the floor price is taking it a step higher, because CryptoPunk also, we don't need even to look at it, because there won't be any for floor price most likely, no. But yeah, you can see that those are still going up in price as well. We know back a few months they were only 300,000. Now they simply explode 400,000 most of the time. And if you consider somewhere sales, 1.8 million, it's also not too bad at all. So NFTs are still worth looking into it. That's basically it. Like and subscribe.